Spicy MedTech here, back again with another video. And in this video, I'm going to discuss and have a mini review of books that you should not leave unread before taking the board exams. Without further ado, let's begin. First, let's break down the contents of the Medical Technology Licensure Exam. So the licensure exam happens in two consecutive days and has six exams containing 100 questions each for a total of 600 questions. And these 600 questions are broken down into four major subjects having a weight of 20% and two minor subjects having 10% weight percentages respectively. 20% goes to hematology, 20% goes to microbiology that includes bacteriology, parasitology, virology, and mycology. Another 20% goes to immunoserology and blood banking, and 20% goes to clinical chemistry. These are the major subjects. And the minor subjects like histopathologic techniques with MT loss and clinical microscopy are weighed at 10% each. Now, for hematology po, we have Rodack, Steininger, Turgeon, at saka Brown. Now, these books have been the source of many board exam questions po for Hema, especially po doon kay Rodack. Out of the four, I personally like Rodack, but reading it is a very big time investment po because it is super in-depth and detailed. And mas updated po ang info doon sa Rodack as compared kina Brown and Steininger. Now, if you don't have time to read Rodack, I highly recommend po yung Turgeon as an alternative. For micro naman po, we have Jowetz and Bailey Scott's. Now, ang dalawang to are very thick books since sakop naman po halos ang whole coverage ng microbiology. Now, same sila ng Rodack. Yung dalawang to ay very detailed and in-depth. But para sa akin po, easier to understand ang Jowetz as compared doon sa Bailey's because if malalim po yung Jowetz, mas malalim po talagang intindihin ang Bailey's. For parasitology po, meron po tayong special mention na reference, which is I'm sure you've heard of, is ang Belisario. Ang Belisario po, kumbaga, ay ang go-to reference dito ng mga medtech sa Pilipinas when it comes to parasitology apart from Henry's. Very well written po ang librong ito, especially po doon sa mga parasites na nakikita natin dito locally sa Pilipinas. Now for ISBB naman po. For blood banking, wala na pong iba kundi ang ating paborito, which is ang Harmoning. Now for IS, ito po yung dalawang main options natin is yung Stevens tsaka po si Turgeon. For Stevens po, mas in-depth po siya doon sa laboratory applications and si Turgeon naman po, more on theory. But I do recommend reading both references since both are equally information-packed and much better po na meron po tayong alternatibong libro for cross-referencing. For clinical chemistry po, pwede po nating gamitin si Bishop and yung review handbook po ni Dean Rodriguez. Now, if you want po na mabilisan pero information-packed, I suggest po dun kay Dean Rodriguez na handbook. Kasi po, ito po ay easy to digest na tapos yung important info po nandoon na. Pero for really in-depth po na reading, pwede po natin gamitin si Bishop. I always say this po, when buying po nung handbook ni Dean Rodriguez, yung genuine copy na lang po, wag po yung photocopy. Since di naman po ganun kalaki yung difference dun sa presyo ng photocopier. For histopath po, wala na po akong ibang alam na reference kundi si Gregorius, aside po sa lecture notes. And for MT laws and ethics naman po, pwede nyo pong gamitin ang thecorpusjuris.com kung saan pwede nyo pong ma-look up ang bawat batas na related po sa profesyon ng medical technology. For clinical microscopy or AUBF po, yung reference po ng marami is yung Strassinger, which is true naman po since ibang questions po ay kinukuha dun sa mga tables ni Strass. However, maganda din po yung clean mic ni Branzell. So, pwede po natin gawin na main reference si Strass, tapos alternative reference or Cross-reference po si Brenzel. For general reference po, almost sa lahat ng subjects except po dun sa localized na MT loss natin is yung tinatawag po natin na Biblia ng mga MedTech, which is ang Henry's po. Sa sobrang laki ng librong to, yung most editions ay split into dalawang libro po, which is very good when it comes to reference values and general laboratory protocol. This is also one of the best reference po when reviewing for the ASCP. For overall review po, ito po yung aking go-to reviewers. Si Hubbard, si Shula, and si Har. Si Hubbard po, full of text and key points po, which is good for recalling information days before the boards. Si Shula po, just like Hubbard, pair with more tables and diagrams. And si Har naman po, is isang compilation ng test questions ng mga major and minor subjects with rationalization po, which is very good since hindi lang po answer ang binibigay, meron din pong explanation. I highly recommend po yung HAR, especially po doon sa magte-take din ng ASCP. That would be all. For more content like this, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe to my channel. Thanks for watching. I hope you enjoyed.